Welcome to my bathroom. Well, it's the only room in the house that I can find a corner that I can hang in. And the best stretch for opening up your chest, which is very hard after 5 or so decades of chronic forward flexion, our chests and its armpits are permanently, it seems, forward crunched. But I found that the doorway stretches don't work as well as the corner stretch. So if your arms are at 90 degrees, you have, you either feet together or 1 foot forward. I would say 1 foot forward. It's just very stressful on the arms to have both feet together. And this way you can control the amount of weight that goes into the stretch. This is a very powerful, you hang for 10 seconds at a time. Because it takes that long for muscle fibers to start letting go. And I would do it at least 3 times in a day. It's very, 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 very effective at getting the pectoralis muscle stretch. It's almost impossible to get that in a doorway. So I was previously just hanging in a doorway and, for some reason, you end up getting more of your deltoid, your bicep, your tricep. It just doesn't work as well. I don't really get it. Why? It's fundamentally different. Everybody's different. But my physical therapist did say, confirmed, that it is a superior stretch. Now, the first time you can do it with your arms at 90 degrees, and then you can raise them a little bit. And then again, maybe put the other foot forward and hang, and you're gonna get slightly different muscles because the muscle of your pectoralis is shaped in a fan. And I would just keep sinking in until, your nose goes into the corner. Boy, I need to wipe these walls down. They're dusty. Oh my God, it is so good. I can't tell you how much better this is than a doorway stretch. I just noticed something. I was letting my head hang forward, and obviously I should do it with a chin tuck. So in other words, retract the chin into the neck and then go forward. And I mean, move the chest in instead of letting the head hang forward. So keeping that chin tuck as you do it. That's the other thing about the value of getting very good at chin tucks is that you'll naturally notice, it's where you didn't expect it, you're hanging, and then it'll pull you back into a safe neck position. It's so intense that you have to come out of it really slowly. You don't want anything to rip. It feels like it might rip. You could also lower your, from 90 degrees, lower it. For your final 10 seconds. So chin's tucked, W shape. Oh man. Definitely move slowly in and slowly out. It's a great stretch. You'll never look at a corner the same way again. Hope you give that a try. Leave me a comment. Let me know how your chest feels after that. Of course, I always like to follow that up with my elbows up and fingertips together behind the head stretch. Rotator cuff stretch. Man, that is just a great stretch. I'm so happy I have a corner. It's funny that in the entire house, there's always a window near a corner, or there's always a piece of art or something. I don't have any really good corners except here in the bathroom. Look at that picture I had made when I was in, it was a pencil drawing done on the
street in Thailand in the year 31, whatever that is.